Hey, how are we doing? Joel from Queens here for part two of my shave den. So join me and I'll show you some of the things I got carried away with, some of the shaving things that I have bought and acquired throughout the last couple of years, and tell me what you think. Alrighty, so these are my soaps. These are the non shaving soaps, the soaps that I use pre-shave or for any other use. But I figured I'll give you a look. First of all, Agua Lavanda Puke. This is the soap that I think it's Gary in Shoebox Shavings that advertises this as the soap that Frank Sinatra used that he made famous. It's a lavender soap, so I have a few bars of it. And I love it too. So if it's good enough for Frank, it's good enough for Joe. So this is one of my favorite soaps that I use in the shower before the shave. Another one of my favorite soaps, Spike. Anything Spike I love. So I always keep a couple of bars of Spike around. I love Spike. So that's always a good pre-shave. I've tried a bar of this before and I liked it. Brute makes a bar of soap. This is Brute. And Klar, they make a lot of shaving things. Klar makes a bar soap. This one I haven't tried yet. I'm probably going to say it wrong. It's from Italy. Felce Azzurra. How's that? That's probably wrong. But I've used some of their other products. They make a good product. They're from Italy. So I'm going to try this eventually. It's a good soap. And I've tried this before, not bad. Florida water soap. I like Florida water, so I have some Florida water soap. Got this as a sample. Hemp. I don't know how legal this is. That's all right. Hemp. It's a hemp lavender Castile's pure Castile soap. So I'm gonna give this a go one of these days. Got this as a sample. And last but not least, I haven't used it. I just bought it more for for decoration from Pastores. This is the Star of David bar soap. It's a kosher soap. I guess there's no animal products in it, but it looked interesting, and I picked it up at Pastores. Then lastly, when the hands are really dirty, something I've always used for many, many years, Baraxo. Baraxo powder, powdered soap. This and Lava, I think, are the most strong soaps that you could buy if you really have dirty hands. These are the products. This and Lava are the most powerful, I think, soap.
Here's great news about two wonderful Baraxo hand cleaning products. First, Baraxo powdered hand soap in a new plastic decorator container. Looks like this on the grocer's shelf, and like this on your bathroom or kitchen sink.
To use without peeling your skin off. So those are my soaps that I use during the shower, whatever, before the shave. All right, and also during our shower, before the shave, some hair care products and face scrubs. We have Makaroot face scrub and a St. Ives face scrub to really get the shave started out. We'll use these two products. Also in the shower, what do we have? We have some Axe shower gel and for shampoos. I like banana. Anything flavored banana I love. This is from the Body Shop and this is a banana flavored shampoo. And we also have Clubman, also one of my favorite lines. Clubman makes a shampoo, so we have that. And Old Spice, anything Old Spice makes is also wonderful. So we have some of this Old Spice Swagger. Swagger. So those are some of the shower products for before the shave. All right, and also part of our shave, we do our oral care. We mustn't forget about our oral care. So I have this time three toothpastes that I like to use. One is Elmex, and this is an Elmex toothpaste. And this is one of my three that I have in stock now. And where was this made? It wasn't made here. It was made in Germany. This is a German toothpaste that I like. And how do you say this? Euthymol? Something like that? Euthymol? And this is also somewhere else. This is from Johnson & Johnson makes this. And it's made in the UK. This is from the UK. You notice how I have this rolled up so nicely? How I did that? Let me show you. I picked this up. It's called the Club. They make a lot of these different rollers for tubes, and I'll roll it up every so often. And look how nicely that works. That's that. And from Italy, Marvis. I've had a couple other flavors. I've had the licorice and another mint. This is the jasmine mint. This is from Italy. And it's a good toothpaste. Lately, I've been trying different toothpastes all the time. Instead of buying Colgate or Crest or one of the regular ones, I like to try something from somewhere else. But my old favorite mouthwash is Lavar's, the cinnamon. Cinnamon flavor, the original. I've used this for many, many years. Now, that's the oral care department. All right, now let's discuss hair care for the little bit of hair that I have left. Mostly every day, Pinard, Clubman, this is the gel. This one is the green one. And they have different colors that have different holds. So this one, I think, it's not the heaviest hold. There's one that's a little bit stronger, but I like this one. It's the green one. And Brill Cream, a little dab will do you. I use this once in a while. And Old Spice Pomade. This is the Swagger. And Jerris Hair Tonic. I use this once in a while, too. So, and I have Vitalis, too. That's almost gone. That's in the hair care department. All right, as you can see, a pre-shave department here. We have a little Noxzema, some Coral Skin Food, and some Irish Mousse in the back hiding, and some Parasso pre-shave, some Cornhuskers, and my own homemade pre-shave oil that I'm going to show you how I make. All right, here's some of my supply here, aside from the Cumballs. Some of the pre-made shave oils here, well, they're not really shave oils, but I use them for shave oils. The vitamin E, the herbal oil, the almond glow, the almond oil. Those I just buy. But I'm going to show you how I take the extra virgin olive oil, and the castor oil, and the grapeseed oil, and the jojoba oil, and add a little of my own flavorings to it, and make my own homemade pre-shave oil. These are some of my essential oils that I have acquired. Rose water, lavender, wintergreen, lemon, peppermint, jasmine, grapefruit, and I add these to my oil. All right, so the recipe, my little recipe that I found on the internet, very simple to make your own pre-shave oil, and it's just as good, if not better, than the ones you buy for a lot of money from some of the shaving sites and the shaving companies that are selling it. So here's what I do. Olive oil from the kitchen. This is from the kitchen. What does Rachel Ray say? EVOO, extra virgin olive oil. So this is all in equal parts. So there's four oils, and they're in equal parts. So if you want to make a big batch, you could do 5-5-5-5, or a small batch, 2-2-2-2, and you put it into little containers, and then you add your essential oils to give it whatever scents you like, you know. I have quite a few, and I made a few of them. So one part EVOO, extra virgin olive oil from the kitchen. Another equal part, castor oil. Don't drink it. But one pot castor oil, one pot olive oil, and another equal pot of grapeseed oil. You get all these in gourmet shops and wherever. And jojoba oil, equal parts. So you mix these four in equal parts. And then as much, depends on the strength you like for the scent, you add your different essential oils. And then you pour it into little containers. You can give it out as gifts. I do that. And that's a great pre-shave oil. You know, like some of them, you know, that you've seen on my array of oils, I just use straight. You know, like the Almond Glow and things like that. I just, you know, bought new straight. That's very good also. But this is four oils, very simple, equal parts. And then you can either do it plain if you want it unscented, or add one of the essential oils. And it's very inexpensive and very easy to do. And try it. You're going to see. You're not going to buy any more pre-made shaving oils. Get ripped off. So give it a shot. Well, as you can see, I've kind of neglected my brush collection. I only have an even dozen. I only have 12 brushes. So that's one of the things I got to start working on. You know. Let me show you my 12 brushes. This is a Burma Shave brush, inexpensive. Tweezer Man, I believe this is. This is one of my first brushes. This one I would take to travel. It's a very inexpensive brush. Also, this Basic Care brush is very inexpensive. It looks a lot like the Wilkinson Sword one. I think it's made by the same company. And this too is a synthetic brush. This one, I don't know. They say, I think, it's supposed to be a Badger, but not a good Badger if it is Badger. Here's another old one. This is an Opal. Satin rubber. An Opal. This is an old brush that I picked up, used. Old brush. And an Omega nylon. This is good for like a soap, a hard soap. Where you want that backbone. This is the one with the backbone. It's very rough and sturdy. Good backbone. This is a good brush for something like that. This is a Made Right Pure Badger. One of my flea market finds. The brush. And the razor and brush from last year. One of my favorites. And my Omega. This is the High Brush. Also one of my favorites. And this is a synthetic. Here's a Badger. It's a Parker. Parker Badger. Parker Badger. And a Samoke. One of my Samokes. And this is a nice brush. And we have a rubber set. Rubber set that I bought used. And an Omega. Is that a boar? Maybe. And that's that. Those are my 12 brushes. I really have to work on my my brush collection, but those are the 12 brushes I have for now. All right, let's discuss the blades that we have. These are the ones I have on display. Some Schick Super Stainless, Gillette Platinum Plus, Persona Super Stainless. Was sent to me from Terry. Where's he from? I think Holland. He's kind enough to send me some Hema blades. I'm going to try this next. This hiding back here, some Persona. And some Schick double-edged blades. Two of those. These I haven't used yet. The Persona 74s. They last forever. And these are for the injector. And some old Gillette Super Blue blades. And some Wilkinson Sword hiding under there. Some Gillette Super Stainless. Two of those, I think. Yeah, two of these. And Super Blue. I love the color scheme of that. And the next row, the Schick Injectors. Plenty of those.
sonar injector. Some more Schick injectors. And what's here? A grip. And a Tecmatic refill. More injectors. And what we got here? Razors. We have a new Super Speed here. And an Atra. And a Vector. Another Tecmatic. Tecmatic. A Bic. And a Wilkinson sword. That one's for Junior. If he wants one, that's going to be his. That's for him. Tecmatic. That's the blades hanging in the living room. Those are the living room artwork, living room blades, hanging up on my Gillette display. All right. How you fixed for blades? Let's take a look. Let's see how we're fixed here for blades. Open up a little display here. And we'll start off with some loose blades, different various loose ones. Some Personas. We have some Supermax Persona. Gem Blue Star Single Edge. Treat Single Edge. Some no-name double edge blades. Gillette. These are from Brazil. That was a nice gift. 7 o'clock, yellow. Chroma. 7 o'clock, black. Nice blade. A loose treat. Trick or treat. McCord. Some Derbies. Laser. Rush card. Dorco. Supermax. The Ultimate, the Feather, that's the Ultimate, sharpest blade, Rush Card. What else we got? Supermax, Gillette, Persona Red, Rapier, Paul Silver, Wilkinson Sword, Rapier, Gillette, Sputnik, Big Ben, Chroma, good blade. This is Kai, also a very good blade. Some more feathers. 7 a.m., Wilkinson Sword Gillette, Zurich, Astra Green, couple of lattice boxes, and what's this? Gillette. And that's what we keep in our little display case. And a big box of Astra Green and a big box of Derbies. And that's our blades. All right, let's discuss the shaving soaps. This is the soap part of the part two of the shave then. I have some shaving sticks. Palm Olive, not much left of it. When it gets very small, I'm going to show you. I have a little wooden container that I put pieces in, and I mix it together, and I make my own shaving soap. Arco stick, Derby stick, and we also have our obligatory couple of pucks of Williams. We have a Wilkinson Sword shaving soap. Love the smell of that. And also Arco. I love the smell of the Arco. Arco soap. We have a Razor Rock Kumba Cheech. We have a Verhuld hand. I don't know if I said that right. Verhuld hand. And here it is. It's the Extra Fresh. Very nice. And one of my favorites here. Tobacco. I also have some tobacco cologne that I use. Boots the Chemist. A little soap here from Boots the Chemist. A lot of you people are watching this. You know you sent this to me. Thank you again. If I start mentioning names, I'm going to leave people out. So a lot of this stuff people sent to me from all over. And you know who you are. Thank you again.
This is a known name. So, and we have some grand staff, different grand staffs here. Grand staffs. And this is the, I got this from Amazon, and I just fill it up with pieces of leftover soaps. And I make my own little mishmash of soap. So these are the soaps. And now we're going to move on. And we'll do the, I think we'll do the tubs, the pots of shaving cream. So let's move on to that. All right, now we're going to move on to the tubs or the pots. As they say in other places, I forgot to show you this Spike shaving stick. That should have been in the last segment. I forgot to show this to you. So we also have Spike. All right. In the pots and the tubs, I see we have a German Street Taylorville Bond Street TOBS. We also have TOBS Lavender. We have TOBS Almond. We have our Macaroot from the Body Shop. And we also have this Taconic, which was made here in New York, Eucalyptus Mint, here in this little tub. So those are the tubs that I have that I switch off and on. And now let's move on to the tubes of shaving cream. I have quite a few of those, so that's going to be a little bit longer. So let's look at the tubes next. All right. What do you say we discuss our shaving creams and tubes this time? I forgot a couple of soaps in the last segment. Colonel Ichabod Kunk, some bay rum amber soap. Forgot to show it to you. And also another gift I received from the West Coast Santa Monica Bay Rum Shaving Soap. That was from John. I'm going to leave names out. Like you'll see a lot of these things that people sent me, Anthony, Ant, Terry, Claudio. So many people sent me things, and I'm leaving names out. So, I don't know. All right, let's look at the tubes. C.O. Bigelow. This is really made by Purasso. You know, I didn't know this before in Manhattan. There's a drugstore this was made for, C.O. Bigelow. And I haven't been there yet. I hate to cheat on Leon, but I have to go there and just take a look at it. I know it's nothing like Pasteur's. But this was made for a drugstore in Lower Manhattan. And maybe I'll go there and take a few pictures, maybe a little video to show you what C.O. Bigelow looks like. It's a real store. I didn't know that. So, C.O. Bigelow, made by Purasso. Barbun, this is Eastern European. It's either Bulgaria or Hungary. I have a matching aftershave with this one. This is very good, very cooling. Got a lot of menthol in it. Boots the Chemist. Sent to me also. Thank you, Ant. I don't want to leave names out, but thank you. And Palmolive. We have a couple of Palmolives. Yeah, the tube with the, this is the one with the menthol. They also make without the menthol. Ingram in the tube. And we have, I think this is from Turkey, Demen from Turkey. And some Old Spice, Almost Gone, very good. Love Old Spice, Almost Gone. Some Old Spice over there. I can't pronounce this, I have no idea. It's from Europe, from Russia or somewhere around there. It's from there. And Arco, some Arco shaving cream. And of course, Spike. And we have some more Arco that we haven't opened yet. We have a couple of Arcos. Love Arco, anything Arco I love. And look at the, you know, you can't beat the prices on these things. You just can't beat it. So we're going to get to these. One of these decades, we're going to get to them. No rush. Derby have their blades. This is their lemon shaving cream. That's Derby. And Bic. I wish I would have had this when I did the Bic shave. But I have some Bic here, so a couple of Bics, different Bics. So I wish I would have had this during the Bic shave. And also, more gifts. Look at that, huh? Some Bolzanos, different Bolzanos here. This one has the menthol and different other Bolzanos. Look at all these Bolzanos, huh? And Figaro. I think this is from Hungary. Figaro. And Paraso. This is the sandalwood Paraso. And very woody. So this stays with you all day long when you use this. So those are the tubes. So that's it all the way up to the shave. I think we're running a little bit long, so if enough people want, I'll do a part three, and I'll do the post-shave, you know, I'll do the aftershave colognes, splashes, the balms, the, you know, the other things that I do post-shave, so maybe we'll save that for another video, if enough people want to see it. So that's about it for now. So it's Labor Day today, so everybody have a great holiday. Hope you all had a great summer. And a great rest of the year coming up. And I hope to talk to you soon. And that's it for now. So Joe from Queens saying take care. And we'll talk to you soon. Bye-bye.